want to show you how you can add somebody to your contacts. You're going to come up here to contacts, and you're going to come on down here to add a contact. Now, there's a couple of key things that you need to know. There are only 5 places that need to be filled out for you to be able to save a contact. You need to make sure you have your first name or that person's first name, their last name, their phone number, and their email or their mailing address. Those are the only 4 things that you need to make sure that you fill out to be able to click save in the system. But let me go over some of these other options just to let you know that you could put them in quickly and later on add things. But if you're putting them in kind of as many as possible and as much information as possible, and like I said, the more information that's provided in your contacts, the better, because it helps for searchability, it allows you to be able to organize things better, and it makes for a more powerful database. So the status: lead, active, inactive, sold, or hot. These are the 5 different statuses that you're able to put them in when it comes to their status. Obviously, their title, first name, last name, suffix, or whatever. Nickname, salutation, if somebody goes by Bill, but his name is Robert or something like that. Not like that's really the 2 names that match, but anyway, there's the nickname there. You could put in the gender, the company, job. You could put in the purchase anniversary. That's awesome. It'll help you remember when to follow up with them each year. The referral information: where did you get that referral from? So you can kind of keep track of all your referrals that you receive and what source is the best lead source. Time frame: are they wanting to look now, or are they needing to sell right now, or is it 1 to 3 months, 3 to 6, 6 to 9 months, or just looking? They will also have that ability when they come to your website on the buyer side of things. They'll be able to provide some of this information too. What type are they? Are they a buyer? Are they seller? Are they both a buyer seller? Are you is it an agent that's in another city or another across town that might be a referral agent, renter, investor, vendor, or other? Subtype. All this is just another way to categorize people, and you're able to kind of categorize them even more specific. Category: you can search by category also. It's a little bit different than groups. I prefer using groups, but then you could also have categories inside of groups, maybe an A client, B client, C client, whatever that is, you would be able to put that in the category here. Of course, here's all the contact information, their emails, secondary emails, all that kind of stuff. Let's come on down here to address. This is the name of the address. So is this the home? Is this the business? Here's the address. Is this the investment property, like the second home? Property type. These are all the different options they have for the property type. What kind of information do they have? Is this, what's the square footage or whatever? Where is it located? Secondary details: this would be a spouse or business partner, whoever you'd probably want to do, and you put their information there. And then you're going to click these 2 things. I'll show you what both of these mean. Number 1, this one right here, it says include this contact in the listing alert campaign. So earlier video, I showed you what those listing alerts were, and I'll show you where they're at. But basically, it says here, the listing alert campaign is a series of 3 emails that encourages a contact to sign up for a listing alert. The text of these emails can be modified in the admin email section. So if I want somebody to, if I add them to the database and I want to prompt them to set up their own listing alert, I would click this button right here. Now, what does that look like? Let me come on up to the top, and I'm going to come up here to admin, and I'm going to go to email, and I'm going to open up another window. Those emails, see where it says listing alert campaign? Those emails, these are the 3 emails that are going to go out. They're already written for you, but if you want to customize them and make whatever you want, you can do so, and then just click save changes. So your first listing alert would go out 2 weeks after you add them to the database. Then the second email would go out 1 month after you've added them to the database, and then 3 months after you've added them to the database. It'll prompt them to sign up for the listing alerts. All right, so let's go ahead and go back. We're going to close this. And we're going to go down here, and that's for this button here. So the second thing that I can click here is this button right here, and it says check here to send welcome email to this contact. So this is an already created email that you can customize, and you can change things, you can add things to. So I could write a whole bunch of stuff if I wanted to. I could put links in there, hyperlinks, and all that kind of stuff in there. So and that's all available. Or I can write my own custom email from the very beginning. Now, where is this email pulled from? If I click to revert to the text, I'm going to come up here to the top, go to admin, email, and I'll open this up again in another window. And you're going to come down here to welcome email. That is where you're going to see these two welcome emails. The email that I was just looking at is this section right here. This is the manually entered. You are manually entering the content, the contact into the database. So when you click that button, this is the email that's going to be saved. So if you wanted to customize that and change that, you would change it here. So I'm going to write this just for fun. Go ahead and click save. You can click preview email and you'll see that it says Darren is a stud right there. But I wanted to show you when I click on revert to default, and you're going to see down here, it's going to say Darren is a stud right there. So the things that I change up here in the manually entered will actually change right here in the default section down here. All right. Good, fantastic. So, and then once I click save, you're going to send an email with, this is automatically going to go out with a username and password for them to be able to log in to the website on your site to be able to search for homes. And I'm going to show you what that looks like. You're going to come down here and you click on preview email. This is the email that they're going to receive, and it's going to say your password is. So when I click on this, watch. It brings them to, and this is just a sample, so it's not opening it all the way in the big thing, but you're going to see it brings them to a place where they're able to, since they would actually be logged in, and I'm not logged in, it would actually bring them to your home page of your website. So that's what that shows you there. So, and then, of course, I've already shown you this, the registered on a website. This is for when somebody comes to your website and registers. So that is how you add somebody to your database, and then you click that button and it sends them that welcome email. If you don't want to send that welcome email, just click save and it will be into the system without sending the welcome email. Now, from this point on, though, if you want to send that welcome email and you've already sent them once into this, you've already put them into the database, and you want to resend that welcome email later on, what you'd need to do is you'd have to come up to your contacts. And so here's me, Yates. You'd come over here to Actions, and you come over here to Resend Welcome Email.